spend your time today? What's it going?
Wrapping up the game from last night in a film session. You know, some things we've been trying to work on that we did at a pretty high level last night. So always having the growth mindset to learn from the game before, and then transitioning into the preparation for the Clippers. As if it was morning shoot around, we wouldn't have a morning meeting or shoot around tomorrow morning. So today was that day.
Obviously really different teams, but are there specific pieces that you take from the Bucks execution that you hope to carry over into Sunday?
Really different teams. You know, I mean, just the general mindset of loading to elite scorers, you know, which Clippers have many of them. So some of those Giannis walls and whatnot, we got to make sure that, you know, we're giving these guys the same type of respect and, scoring the ball, offensive execution, I think was really pivotal in that third quarter run for us against the Bucks. And, you know, that's just one of the things that, we're going to need to beat the Clippers. You know, we got to execute offensively.
Is Dan
going to
play tomorrow?
No.
What does he need to get in before you would start integrating him into the
It's probably going to be a few games.
Okay.
Just until he hasn't played all year. You know, Keith was different. He had been playing, playing games for the Pistons. And, Dan's played three games this year. So it's a matter of acclimating, getting used to our system, getting a few practices under his belt.
What is it about them in the last two games that gave you the most trouble when you look back at film and look at those games?
I just think they're a complete team. You know what I mean? They give a lot of people trouble. We look more at kind of the coverages we want to get in place and the matchups. Obviously we let Lou get going and we let Kawhi get going too much. And PG hurt us with shot fakes in the second half last game. They hurt you in a lot of different ways, but we just got to play a more game.
The fact that they've added more pieces, that make it a little bit trickier to even...
Well, they've added some good players. You know, Reggie and Marcus, are just really valuable pieces for them. You know, both of them can hurt you in a variety of different ways and are starter level guys. And, it just makes them deeper.
Markieff has had a couple moments, I think, of the Memphis game kind of stood up for Dwight, if I recall. I mean, does that personality add, like, a toughness to the team?
Of course. I love it. You know, he's one of those guys that you want on your side, you know, that you're concerned about if he's on the other team. But, he's a stand-up for teammates type of guy. He is a toughness type of guy, competitor, and adds to your edge and, your nastiness, you know. So it's one of the things I love about Markieff.
After watching film, what are sort of the biggest takeaways that you have going into tomorrow's game?
Watching the film of the Clippers? Well, again, we just have to execute offensively. You know, I feel good about our coverages. It's, they make things very difficult with the firepower that they have. So we just got to be, really dialed into the execution of our coverages and then make sure that we're, executing offensively so we can share the basketball and get great shot quality on that side of the floor.
Obviously you guys carry sort of a competition mindset in every game. We believe we can win every game, but this season, the regular season matchups with the Clippers, is it important to win one of these regular season matchups to have that mental edge? We have beaten these guys?
Not really. You know, the regular season games, at the end of the day when the playoffs come around, don't really matter. For us, it's just about getting better. Believing that every time we take the floor, we can beat anybody when we're at our best. And no matter what happens tomorrow, it's going to change that.
Is there any injury concerns with any of your guys for tomorrow? Any injury report?
There's some soreness, not anything that – I'm not sure how we're listing guys. But there are guys dealing with some soreness.
Are you – go ahead.
I think it's probably been about a week since you were asked about coronavirus, and there's been more information and obviously more cases. Has that become a bigger part of what you guys have talked about internally over the last few days?
Just educating our guys. We did have a meeting with our team doctor today, just to kind of pretty common sense type of stuff. Wash your hands, avoid contact with others type of things. And,
you know, but we have sort of a, we did have a meeting to address and just educate our guys a little bit further on it.
Is Deion being held out of things in practice too as he sort of gets his conditioning up? And
No, he's in all the practice. In fact, he scrimmaged today with a couple guys that didn't play a lot last night and with some of our video guys. So he'll be in all the practice work that we do. But, you know, this time of year, there's not a lot of practice time. So, but we manufacture it, you know, so that we're making sure that he's getting, because the biggest thing with him is, getting his legs under him, you know, so the more he can play 5-on-5, the better.
This is generally a time when, you know, teams are condensing and tightening rotations and stuff like that. Is it, how hard is it to kind of balance bringing in two pretty new guys and figuring out roles for them?
It's difficult. I'm not gonna lie about that, but it's there's such value in having these two guys on our team, you know, come playoff time that everybody's gonna benefit from it, and everybody sees the value in it. So it's tricky just making sure that they're getting some minutes to get acclimated without impacting the rhythm of the other guys.
All right. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Frank.
Thanks. Thank you.